What's up, guys? Reckless here. We're back again with another Destiny 2 guide, and this time we're going after the catalyst for Agger's Scepter that was just released into Destiny 2. And as you can see in the background gameplay, we are inside of Astral Alignment, and that's because, unfortunately, as of right now, the only way to get this catalyst to drop is a random drop chance in the chest that you get when you complete an Astral Alignment event at the very end. Luckily, the random drop chance for this catalyst is actually relatively high. It didn't take me too many of these Astral Alignment matches to finally get it to drop. And after the RNG powers that be in Destiny 2 decide to smile upon you, you will get the catalyst to drop from the Astral Alignment matches. It took me about 10 matches to get it to finally drop, but your results may vary. And so what it says that we have to do is defeat combatants while using the weapon to unlock this upgrade. Defeating combatants with precision damage will unlock this objective faster, and obliterating destructible walls in the Shattered Realm grants additional progress. If you guys want to go the Shattered Realm route, you absolutely can. You're going to be looking for those shiny rocks that have the blue sparkly effect on them that only Agger's Scepter can do damage to. But for me, I'm going to show you guys a different way to do it in case you don't want to mess with the Shattered Realm. You can just go and load into the moon, and you just go play Altars of Sorrow, where there's gonna be tons of enemies, and you just strap on Agger's Scepter and go nuts. So for those of you that don't know, you're gonna have to load into Sorrow's Harbor to do the Altars of Sorrow that I'm talking about on the moon here. So as you load into the area, you're just gonna be looking for these giant green hive magic spires like you would for the Altar of Sorrow public events, and then you're just going to strap on Agger's Scepter and go nuts and kill enemies. As you can see on screen here, playing one Altar of Sorrow round going brought us up 14% from zero. So if you want, you can just chip away at it that way, playing Altar of Sorrow and completing it out through that way. I am gonna run into the Shattered Realm just to show you guys what rocks you're looking for in order to get these nodes that it claims, the destructible barriers that it says gives you more progress. So when you load into the Shattered Realm, you saw the path that I took on screen here. What you're looking for is a little rock node like I have in front of me here that has sort of a void energy aura to it that it's giving off where it glows. And if you shoot it with a regular weapon, you're gonna see that it pops up immune on the damage. But if you shoot it with the Agger's Scepter, you're gonna see that it glows and then blows up. So essentially, all you're gonna wanna do is run around the Shattered Realm and find those sparkly purple and black rocks and destroy them with the Agger's Scepter, and that's gonna get your progress going significantly faster versus just killing regular enemies. And we finally have the catalyst. For me, grinding it this way took about an hour and a half, 2 hours, so you're gonna have to buckle up and get ready for a grind with these kills for this one. But let's take a look at it. So once you've upgraded the catalyst, it says it'll generate orbs after rapidly defeating combatants and gain a tracker that displays the number of them defeated with it. The Masterwork weapon will also receive additional capabilities. So then it goes on to say, long pressing square for PlayStation, is going to drain super energy, overflowing the magazine and empowering the beam with bonus damage and the ability to slow and freeze targets until the magazine or your super energy runs out or the weapon is stowed away. This can only be activated when super energy is full. So with this catalyst and the masterwork, you're getting a damage boost capability. So I've yet to see how the damage is going to be increased with this catalyst. I'll have to test it out and do a video on that later. But you're getting a significant damage boost with the sacrifice of your super energy. That is it for how to get Agar's Scepter's catalyst. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any comments, concerns, questions, drop them down in the comment section below. As always, if you do like the videos, give me a thumbs up so I know what content you guys are going to be interested in that I can keep making. And of course, if you feel so kind, drop me a subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you guys can stay up to date with all the videos and you don't miss a thing. I'll catch you on the next one, guys.